neutral site action, and we're just about set to kick off. This coin toss presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. USC is ready to open this one up as they line up for the opening kick. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 23. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Throws complete and he's hit right away. Caught out of the open. Out of bounds around the 35-yard line. Gain of 6 on the pass, and that's good for a first down.
Heads-up play by the quarterback to find his receiver in traffic and get the ball into his hands.
And the quarterback didn't waste any time getting rid of that one. He took the snap, and he threw it right out there. They'll bring him down around the 37-yard line. Gets it. He's in space. He's pushed out of bounds at the 45. That play is good for 8 yards and a first down.
And still, this gunslinger hasn't missed a receiver yet on this drive.
Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And they make the stop at the 47-yard line.
You know what? After a play like that, I wouldn't be the least bit surprised if they went to the air again.
Fires that quickly, incomplete. And there wasn't anyone in the vicinity.
I think the ball just slipped out on him.
So the referee is going to take a look at several angles. Now remember, he's seeing the same thing we are, and he needs indisputable video evidence to overturn the call. So the official's taking a look at this play to see if the receiver got a foot in bounds.
Regardless of the outcome of this review, I still think that this guy made an excellent catch.
So after the review, they reversed the call on the field. Throw it in a hurry. There's a strike complete. He's down. Just throws this one away. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four.
Four down. Mark 55.
Fires out to his receiver. He gets hit out of bounds at the 32.
The offense only got the first down by about a yard, but I'm sure they'll be happy with a new set of downs.
The middle for a nice game.
Nice play, man.
Call it a game of 6 yards.
That'll make it second and four.
There's a strike complete, and he's tackled at the 24-yard line. To the 22-yard line. They'll be short of the first down after that unsuccessful running play.
Nice job here by the defense of holding firm and forcing a fourth down.
Fourth down,
So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. First down, pick up by the tailback.
You can see how comfortable this guy is with that football in his arms.
And down he goes at the 18. To that quickly. Tackle at the 17. Caught a big hit there to stop it. So it's fourth down. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. Auburn is looking to go up by three. He gets it up, and it is good. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And he makes it out to about the 17-yard line. USC's offense, a lot of times they can spread things out and they can really be versatile offensively. But when you got a wide receiver like this, it really helps the
cause. It does, and it continues to help with what they're trying to do. They're trying to find matchups. And when you have one player like this that the defense has got to be aware of, they're going to spread you out, try to find a one-on-one matchup. If you spend too much time with this one player, they've got some other weapons to make you pay for it.
From their own 12-yard line, second down. Toss gets to about the 14-yard line. Take him down immediately. He really got a hold of that one. He makes it out to midfield. After a quarter of play, we got a low-scoring defensive battle on our hands. 3-0, Tigers. We can only hope the second quarter is as good as the first. Tight ball game, folks. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Auburn holds a field goal lead. Run left side. And he's taken down at the 40-yard line. That makes it first and 10. Tackled at the 41-yard line.
He was never able to get ahead of steam on that carry.
Second down and 11 yards to the sticks. Ball on the 41-yard line. He's taken down right around the 18-yard line. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
Tackled after decent pickup.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That brings him second and 5.
Mark 55! Let's go! Thank you! Come here!
Here's an opening. Touchdown, Auburn. He makes the PAT. So a five-play, 51-yard drive. It's good for 7 points.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. It can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 25. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Complete and taken down immediately. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He's to the 40. Brought down in the open field.
Very well designed play that time to give them a first down. The linemen executed their blocks nicely, and it went for a good game.
Second and nine. Ball on the 49. Check right. And he's stopped behind the line. The first down, so they'll have to punt this one away.
The defense held their ground on that play. The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open receivers.
These special teams have done it before, blocking punts. It looks like they're coming after this one. Booming kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
Tackle made at the 19. Again. Nice run, and he's brought down. That'll bring up 36. He's got it with room to run. They'll bring him down right around the 48-yard line.
He
gets to about the 41-yard line. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. And he is drilled at the 28-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 28-yard line. That's a great tackle at the 14.
It's a great job here by the quarterback of recognizing the outside linebacker blitz and delivering the football for a first down.
And he makes it out to about the 14-yard line. He's lucky just to get back to the line of scrimmage on that option. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 14-yard line. Big opening. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
Gain of 7 on the play. That makes it 3-3.
Quick throw, and they got to him before he could get back to the line. They lose 3 yards there.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
This one should be makeable. Kick is up, and they tack on 3 points. The Tigers wideout out with an apparent injury, although he might make a comeback before this game's over. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. USC's offense is so predicated on what this wide receiver does, and now when you consider that we've got a couple of quarters left, they've got to change the complexion of the game a little bit. They're going to have to do it with somebody else, I think.
This is really where a coaching staff gets challenged, because for 5 or 6 days, you prep. And you look at a lot of film, and you kind of come into a game by the time Saturday rolls around, and you have a good idea of how you want to attack the defense. And then you go out there, and it's not working. And you have to show an ability as a coaching staff to go back and look at that drawing board and eliminate some things and maybe add some things, and be able to try to make the adjustments you need to give your team a chance to win in the second half.
We're halfway through, and it's been a good one. 13-0, Tigers.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. There is nothing, and I mean nothing, that is more important than turnover. Now, so far, neither defense has been able to force one in this game, but you never know when that opportunity is going to come up.
No, and people look at turnovers and they assume that it's luck a lot of times, but a lot of times it's preparation. It's being able to know that when certain teams line up, like South Carolina back in 2002, in a certain formation where it's Tucson open stud, and they got 3 receivers to my side, and I know it's a rollout pass. As a defensive end, I widened my stance a little bit, came upfield, hit the quarterback as he was throwing it. Next thing you know, the ref signals his hands up in the air, and you get 6 points for it. So you can definitely be prepared, and that's how you force those turnovers.
That's going to do it at halftime. Just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, bro. I'm going to get something to the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
But look, wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk, take the second half.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Tigers continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Caught, open field. And they make the stop at the 35-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 35-yard line. Throws it out right to the running back. And he's tackled around the 36-yard line.
That's a gain of 1 on the play. That brings up second and 9.
just throws this one away.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
And he's level at the 40. First and 10. Ball on the 40. Nice gain as he works the right side. Up again on third down. Quick pass, man open, and he dropped it.
Number 85, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it fourth and four.
The kick is up. It's got the distance. And he nails the long field goal.
You know, I was wondering if he's going to get a chance to kick one of those. We saw him warming up from 60 yards before the game.
13-3, Auburn. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. At the 30. And he's shoved out of bounds at about the 35.
It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold?
They'll get him for a loss.
Excellent job by the defense to diagnose the play so quickly. This is really a well-coached unit.
Second down and 12. Ball on the 33. It's the tailback. Gets to around the 42. The quarterback has some room. He's at midfield. Gains his way to the 43-yard line. Back with the carry. He fights forward to about the 40. Run right side, and he makes it out to about the 37-yard line.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it 35.
He's out of bounds around the 35-yard line. Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Nice run up the middle. Tackle at the 17-yard line.
First down.
He might have a chance.
What a play, and that is first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
Touchdown, Tigers. He splits the uprights with the extra point. The Tigers saw one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the action.
He sends this one deep. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Here they go on the draw, and they'll lose yards. Second and 13. Ball on their own 22.
My five. Here we go. Line 80.
Makes the catch, and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss. They get a one-yard loss on that one.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
Third and 14. Ball on the 21-yard line. Complete. Brought down. Nothing doing.
That'll bring up fourth and 13.
Oh, excellent punt. He gets out to about the 38-yard line. And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
Throws a laser across the middle. He's tackled at about the 43-yard line. The offense was pretty successful on that play there.
That was a very good passing play to get the ball downfield for a very nice gain and a first down.
He's taken down at the 32.
That makes it first and 10.
And he's taken down around the 24-yard line.
That's a gain of 8 on the play. That makes it second and 2.
And 2, blue 4, go!
Makes it to the 14.
Makes the set play. That's a gain of 10 on the play. First down.
Check, tight right. So at the end of 3, the Tigers lead 20-3. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number 4. It's out to around the 6.
That makes it 2.
And he hits him hard at the 5-yard line.
Penalty clock's at zero. They took too much time.
Delayed game. Offense.
They'll line up for another third down play because of the penalty.
Well, here you're in a third down situation, and then someone makes a mental mistake. It makes your blood boil if you're a coach.
Third and six. Ball on the 10-yard line. Fires to his tight end. Nothing doing. He gets it up, and it is good. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The defense really shut these guys down the last time they had the ball. And he's immediately tackled. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 38-yard line. Quickly incomplete.
You know, sometimes the toughest throws to make for a quarterback is when he has a wide receiver wide open, and everybody in the stands is saying, throw it, and you aim the football instead of just getting back in rhythm, stepping, and throwing. And that time, he aimed the ball, and it was incomplete.
Catches it, and that's all. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. Down around the 43-yard line. And he tackles him hard at the 49-yard line. Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. Less than 3 minutes in the game. He's going right.
Just got hit and hit hard. If I'm an offensive coordinator, especially an offensive line coach, I'm getting a hold of my offensive line, making sure these guys are on the same page. And they've got to take more pride in taking care of their quarterback than that play right there.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. Doesn't look like he's going to have much time to get rid of this punt. It's away, and it's a booming punt. Gets to about the 27-yard line. Auburn's proven to be the better team in every facet of this football game.
Boy, their defense has played lights out. Their offense is taking advantage of their opportunities. Everything has led them to a very comfortable lead.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Up the middle for a nice gain. It's second down, six to go. Ball on the 31-yard line. He's to the 40. They'll bring him down around the 49-yard line.
You like to see a team having success like this running the football. It can really open up things for the offense.
A A little over a minute in the game. Tackle made at the 49.
No gain on the play. That makes it second and 10.
From their own 49-yard line. Second down. On the ground, right side. He makes his way to about the 42.
That's good for a gain of 9 yards. Third down.
USC's staff and really this entire team, I'm sure, is going to rally around this kid.
Yeah, it's a tough loss for this team. I mean, they put so much into this game. But one thing about them is they're a team. And even though their star player had a tough game, I think they'll pick him back up and get him ready to go by next week.
That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.